Hello, this is not a spring chicken. Yes, Prince William and Catherine, otherwise known as the Duke and Duchess, are in, well, actually, they're not quite here in Southern California, but they will be here later today, and I don't know about you, but this is, well, let's just say, it has been one of those odd days. So the chances of us being over there, well, actually, any other media other than, well, a few broadcast media. Well, and there'll be plenty of paparazzi, like, waiting out, way out, waiting for them to come by. But as far as regular credential media, yeah, right, we tried a long time ago. And it just had to do with all those layers and layers and layers of, well, clearances. Anyway, we're going to, the news still continues, even though, yes, you think things have come to a standstill here in L.A. We're going to bring Oldecam on with comments on the headlines of today. For a second straight month, the jobs report is just a bump in the road.
I know, this guy is totally incompetent, folks. I mean, if this was a Republican president, they would be charged. I mean, I heard it last night. More liberals are saying impeachment because
really,
yeah, they said he's incompetent. He doesn't care about what's going on, and that the simple fact is that if it was a Republican, they'd have that Republican government up on stock manipulation because they're letting things loose. You know, the rumor mill that things are doing so great and they're doing great well. Let's see, the retail sales are up, and then it turns out the retail sales are only up against last year, which means they're way down, and today all the retail stocks tank. Well, we only had 2,000 people less apply for jobs this week than they did last week, but there was only 18,000 jobs created.
Mm-hmm.
18,000 jobs created. You know they lost more than,
mm-hmm.
they lost more than that 2,000 folks, so.
Mm-hmm. And Monty Bubbles has a visit from Prince William.
Oh yeah, I mean we know that everybody knows that Monty Bubbles in her alter ego, you know, little girly Bow Wow, is one of the hottest bitches this nation has ever known, and it's a secret that on William's wedding night that he went over with the London Philharmonic Orchestra and basically going, this is a, they didn't know he could sing, but he's going, little Monty Bubbles. Little girly Bow Wow, will you please be mine till the end of time? Little girly Bow Wow, little Monty, please be mine till the end. So this is unbelievable. Really, he's got a voice in the music industry.
Wow, that was really good.
I didn't even hear him when he came over today. Police was everywhere on the street because he did come over to serenade Monty today.
And there was helicopters flying over Monty's house.
And she's basically very nonchalant about everything.
Mm-hmm. She did let him scratch her tail.
Yeah.
The White House float. And of course, we're just kidding.
We just about things like that. That's called satirical singing, folks. So there.
But there was increased security.
Oh God! You would
and helicopters
over here.
And White House floating, raising the debt limit with no cuts, all on his own. Just a threat now, but in the works.
Okay, they're letting it be known that under the 14th Amendment of the Constitution, the President of the United States has the right to basically change the debt. He has the right to issue bonds and all of this stuff on his own. There's a provision that is stuck away that has been not used, and it's a threat. And I can guarantee you, you know, here's Mad Bull. Mad Bull says if he pulls this, he's got to be thrown out of office. They have basically told him. This is what they were talking about last night. I'm talking people to the real left that would be in danger of winning re-election if a president of the United States took it on his own to usurp the total power of Congress. One of the people on the left said, we got to get rid of this man. He needs to be impeached.
Mm-hmm.
And I will vote in the Senate to impeach him. So yeah. He's in trouble, folks.
And suspect in Michigan shootings commits suicide.
I know. I'm going to go back to my father said, we'll put it this way. My father was a police officer in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. And my father said, it was always amazing how many times the guy that's going to fight to the death always committed suicide.
Mm-hmm.
And he always committed suicide with a bullet to the back of his head, which they always thought that was interesting also.
Mm-hmm. And Lockheed's aeronautics unit to cut 1,500 jobs.
Yeah, because they're not selling planes. Nobody has any money. Only the President of the United States thinks the world is lying about being broke.
Oh.
Yeah.
And White House pushing more government spending to get people back to work.
Oh, this, I mean, I'm going to call him because, oh, you have to, I don't have Jack in the Box Obama here, but if I did, you'd basically, he basically represents the best of Obama. What we need to do is to put a government spending program in to increase jobs. And if we spend money, if we spend a government jobs program, that will increase, he put a government jobs program and lost 2.5 million jobs, and the unemployment rate went to 9.2%.
Oh, really?
That was following his government jobs program. They said, well, if it didn't work, keep doing it until you no longer have any money.
And people that live on boats are now listed as millionaires by the Democrats.
Oh, yeah. That's Mad Bull Obama, he's really in a rage today. We've seen some of those millionaires over Marina Del Rey. They've got a 20-foot boat, and they got, okay, here it works. If you have a bathroom on board the boat, if you have a galley on board the boat, and if you have a phone line through the boat, you are a house, and only millionaires can afford to live on their boats. And because they're millionaires, we're going to take away their tax breaks because they live on a boat instead of in a house. Only millionaires can afford to live on a boat.
No.
I know people on 20-foot boats in Marina Del Rey that have no money. The boat is all they have, and they're basically a monthly check to pay the dock fees and mm-hmm. stuff. But they're, you know, boat like night. Okay, you can park over there for like you can buy a boat for as low as $20,000 and spend the rest of your life living on it. Does that make you a millionaire? According to Barack Hussein Obama, that makes you a millionaire.
I know, and then you have to pay the dock fees.
Yeah, it's like so much per foot on your boat, which mm-hmm. means they try to put the smallest one they can in there if you're retired.
Mm-hmm. And baseball fan dies after falling from the stands at the Rangers game.
Okay, here's the problem. The upper decks have no, there's nothing to cover people. When you lunge after a baseball, there's a foul I've seen people. Basically, I went to a baseball game where Lou Kraus became the youngest player in the history of baseball. He's never been changed. He pitched a one-hitter. You know, almost pitched a no-hitter. He only gave up one hit, no bison ball, nobody on base. But a man wanted a foul ball from the game, and he lunged over the railing, and he said that was what brought an end to Lou Kraus's career because he saw that happening, and if he had to have one more out to go, he changed his pitching style after he saw the guy jump fall to a death. And he was never the pitcher he was after that one inning. Because he just sat there and he wanted to get the game over. And he threw his arm out trying to get out of that inning. Sitting out there for, okay, here's the trick is, you don't pull a pitcher that's pitching a perfect game on his first game ever from the game. You don't pitch him. You know, he gave up the hit in the ninth inning. But he gave up the hit because of the
guy. After the guy had already fallen.
Yeah.
Oh, that's sad.
That is sad, yeah.
Wow. Obama defends record in campaign style Iowa stop.
He goes to a place that basically is now out of business. He went to a place that folded after he went there. They folded because they can't afford to continue to do business. Isn't that brilliant? Everywhere he's going, this is a shining example of how Obama's programs have worked, and then like the next, they basically stay in business so he can do his photo ops.
Oh, that's horrible though.
I know. Again, they have to pay people 30 days extra salary because they should have shut down, but they didn't shut. The President of the United States wants to drop by this steel factory to show everybody how much his plans have helped, and then they shut down, but they have to pay money. They have to pay for the privilege of Obama coming there and showing how much work, how great his system has been.
Breaking news, Bush and the Republicans are responsible for cheating on tests by teachers in Atlanta and elsewhere. Now that sounds like the most ridiculous thing.
They say they're forcing teachers to give tests to the students that the students can't possibly pass. So they're basically fudging on all of the scores and everything. You know, well, we can't have a test because it's unfair to minorities. It's unfair to illegal aliens. It's unfair to everybody that actually got education.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but Bush and Republicans forced that upon the teachers union, and the teachers union are demanding Obama remove all of these restrictions that you actually have to know what you're supposed to be doing.
And the coming of Carmageddon of a closed 405 in L.A.
Yeah, we know about Carmageddon because we have to travel up and down.
Oh, geez, we've been hearing about it for at least the last month or 2 months.
Well, it's not going to be a big deal. They're only going to take a bridge out. In two days, they're going to take a bridge out.
Yeah, but they're closing the 405 freeway from the 10 miles to the 101 freeway for 10 miles?
For 10 miles. And you're going to put, and they're canceling major events that were supposed to be being done at the same time. Big motorcycle rallies for Jay Leno, for a charity. Things are being, actually they're being moved where they can't make any money with that. But we know, where we live on, we basically, Sepulveda is the main street. They have been working on the street for 2 months and haven't accomplished anything. They're going to totally tear down the Sepulveda overpass in 2 days and not cause any damage to the road beneath it.
Somehow.
We saw how they're working on the road. They've got to redo the road to repair the damage that they did to the road while they were repairing the road. So you can't use the road.
Mm-hmm. And decline in home. Oh, yeah. So what they've advised is for people either to stay home or get out of town.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of people are getting out of town, so.
Decline in home price ebbs. Consumers gloomy.
The pending sales are all down because of the fact that the appraisals are coming in lower than the bids for the homes. So you can't borrow money to buy the home, even if you could borrow money to buy a home.
And Democrats demand higher taxes and talks about cuts in programs to be discussed in 12 years.
That would be the ultimate thing. I mean, I find this one has got to be for BS the poll. Can you imagine Republicans considering raising taxes with no guarantee there's going to be any budget cuts?
Yeah.
They told them, you do that, just don't bother coming back to your office because we're going to just throw you out of office now, not wait till 2/12, folks. I mean, so this morning, they're taking a hardened attitude, knowing that we're talking across the board. The whole Republican constituency is telling them, you raise taxes and no cuts, do not bother to even come back to your office because you're gone.
And Dodgers win court approval for a $60 million bankruptcy loan.
Which pissed off Major League Baseball because what's going to happen is the courts are going to rule in favor of a court, not in favor of baseball because he has a legal right to use money to pay his bills. It's supposed to be a business.
It is a business, isn't it?
And they're saying that the loan that he was going to get that would have paid for everything couldn't be done because he might have taken money from that loan to help pay off his bills. It is a business, folks. You buy a baseball team, a lot of people buy baseball teams to make money off of them.
Uh-huh.
So.
And California delays its carbon trading program.
Because, first of all, it doesn't work. So what it means is, well, we're going to sell carbon tax, we're going to sell carbon things. What we're going to do is we're not going to use nuclear energy, and by not using nuclear energy, we're going to be able to sell what we're not using.
Oh,
I'm
way over, because you're like, Anamonte Bubblism from the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom.
Okay. This one is for Bill O'Reilly, who basically did everything but say, God damn America. Over to Casey Anthony, but he said, you know, this is a, you know, corrupt this, corrupt that. America is corrupt. He just basically did nothing but condemn our country. If you don't like this country, Mr. O'Reilly, then get the hell out of it. So.